Myself, Narayana Reddy. I am from Math YouTube channel. Today in this class, I am explaining about Binomial Theorem. Binomial Theorem is very important for expanding, like x plus y whole square, x plus y whole cube, xy whole to the power of 4, etc. x plus whole to the power of 100, whatever it is. So, for the expansion, we can use Binomial Theorem. But, there is one important point which you have to observe. Here, so many terms are there. For example, 100 terms. But we want to find out middle term. How to find? What is the value of the middle term? So for that purpose, we can use Binomial Theorem. Those are depends on binomial coefficients. Those binomial coefficients can be find easily from Pascal triangle. Already told in last video. Okay? So, that is the relationship between Pascal triangle and binomial coefficients. Okay, dear friends, see here. Binomial theorem. What is by? 2. Binomial theorem. Binomial means, which means two terms connected by either plus or minus. Listen carefully. There are four operators are there in mathematics. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. But in binomial, we can use only two operations, that is addition and subtraction. That is plus and minus. That is binomial. That is what is called binomial theorem. Binomial means only two operators can be used. Those are plus and minus. That is why this is called binomial theorem. That's all. Binomial means only two terms can be added or subtracted. That's all. Not multiplication, not division. Okay, dear friends. See here. X plus y whole to the power of 1 equals to x plus y. Here index is 1. Our exponent is 1. So 1 plus 1, n plus 1 terms. So x plus y. X minus y whole to the power of 1. X minus y. Here minus is there. So plus is there and minus is there. That is why we can use binomial. That means only plus or minus. Here one important point which you have observed. What is that point means? Binomial is not a scientist name. It is not a mathematician name. It is only used in two operators, that is plus or minus. That is why this is called binomial. You can form a sentence, form a expression by using these two operators is called binomial theorem. That's all. So dear friends, binomial is nothing but plus or minus operators, and by using these operators we can form an expression is called binomial theorem. That's all. Binomial is not a mathematician name or scientist name. Okay? So, here n equals to 1, terms are 2. Here also same, n equals to 1, terms are 2. Here n equals to 2, n equals to 2, terms 3. Here n equals to 3, terms 3, plus minus, plus is there, minus is there. So whenever index is n, number of terms are n plus 1. If for number of n is 100, number of terms are 100 plus 1, that is 101, 101, okay? Then continue the indexes. X plus y whole to the power of n is equals to x to the power of n plus dash y to the power of n. So first and last coefficients are 1, that is n plus 1 terms. N plus 1 terms. Okay? In this way, we can expand the all the values by using binomial theorem. Here we can use binomials. What are binomials? Plus or minus. That's all. Okay? Binomial theorem. Already you know about binomials. Binomials are nothing but plus or minus. Those are binomials. Okay. Here, theorem is, binomial theorem is, that means you can add, you can group together plus or minus to form an expression. That is called binomial theorem. Okay. What is binomial theorem? See here, let n be a positive integer. N be a positive integer. And x, a be real numbers. Then, x plus a whole to the power of n. Here, x, a are real numbers. N be a positive integer. How to expand? N is 0, x to the power of n, a to the power of 0. What is n is 0? I will tell you. Just right. Next one is NC1, x to the power of n minus 1, n to the power of 1. Observe here, what happening, what is going on. NC0, NC1, so 0 plus 1, 1. N minus 1, that means here exponent of xn and exponent of a is 0. The next term, exponent of x n minus 1, that means 1 decreasing, and exponent of a is 1, that is 1 is increasing. Here x is decreasing, a is increasing. Two terms. The next term, in third term, nc2, x to the power of n minus 2, a square. nc2, x is decreasing by 2, exponent decreases by 2. First term is n, third term is n minus 2. Here, first term is a to the power of 0 and third term is a square, means increasing. Please observe here, x is decreasing and a is increasing. Here also same, nc3, x to the power of n minus 3, a cube, nc4, x to the power of n minus 4, a to the power of 4, means x is decreasing, a is increasing. In this way, ncr, x to the power of n minus r, a to the power of r, plus that as ncn, x to the power of n, a to the power of n. Ncn, x to the power of 0, a to the power of n. So, starting is x to the power of n and end is a to the power of n. In this way, you can write the, expand the, all the terms by using binomials. That is binomial theorem. Okay? So, you can expand all the terms by using binomials. That is called binomial theorem. In binomial theorem, we can use NCR. NCR. What is NCR? NCR is nothing but factorial n by factorial r into factorial n minus r. This is called factorial. This symbol is called factorial. This can also be called it as factorial. This is also called factorial. Both are same. Okay? What is factorial n? N into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3. Dash. Factorial. I will write simple example for factorial. Factorial 5 equals to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 5 into 5 minus 1 into 5 minus 2 into 5 minus 3. 5 minus 4. That means 20, 60, 120. Therefore, factorial 5 equals to 120. So, this is expansion in binomials, binomial theorem. Okay? Next one is NCR. NCR, I will write an example. 5C3. Here, this can be compared with NCR. Yes? Implies N equals to 5, R equals to 3. Okay? What is NCR? NCR equals to factorial N by factorial R into factorial N minus R. Yes? Factorial N, factorial 5 divided by factorial R, factorial 3, N minus R, 5 minus 3 equals to factorial 5 by factorial 3, factorial 2, 5 minus 3. Now expand that one. 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Same manner, 3 into 2 into 1, factorial 3, into factorial 2, 2 into 1. This one cancel. 3, 2, 2 is 4, 3, 3 cancel. So, 5 is 10. That is, 5C3 equals to 10. Therefore, 5C3 equals to 10. In this way, you can find the values in say 5C10, 5C6, 5C5, 10C5, 100C6, whatever it is. We want formula, that's all. Parallel N by parallel R into parallel N minus R. By using this formula, you can find any value. See here again one time. NCR 5C3. N is 5. R is 3. Parallel N by parallel R into parallel N minus R. Parallel 5. By factorial 3 into 5 minus 3, 2. So expand this one, 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that is factorial 5. Factorial 3, 3 into 2 into 1, and factorial 2, 2 into 1. 2 into 1, 2 into 1 gets cancelled. 2, 2 is 4, this one cancel. 3, 3 cancel. 4 into 2, 10. So in this way, you can find the 5C3 value. Again, you can find so many values by using this one. Okay, see here, general term. What is general term? General term is nothing but required term. Which term you want? Which term you want to find out? So for that purpose, we can use this formula. In expansion, x plus a whole to the power of n. X plus a whole to the power of n. Binomial expansion. Binomial expansion. We can expand the expression by using plus or minus. That is called binomial expansion. It's nothing but binomial theorem. Yes or not? So, x plus a whole to the power of n, the r plus 1th term is called the general term of the expansion. What is general term? TR plus 1 equals to NCR x to power of n minus r into the power of r for 0 less than or equal to r less than or equal to n. That means r less between 0 and n. R less between 0 and n. Range. R less between 0 and n means range. Suppose x plus 1 whole square is there. What is the range? 0 to range. That is the range. 0 to 2. So it can't exceed 2. Here also x plus a whole to the power of n means which can't exceed n. Maximum is n, minimum is 0. That is r less between 0 and n. That is the meaning. Okay? So NCR x to the power of n minus r, x to the power of r. This is the general term, r plus 1 term. Same manner, rth term. Here is r plus 1 term. But rth term, very, very important. Rth term equals to tr equals to same formula. Tr equals to what? You can subtract 1 from this one, that's all. Tr plus 1 minus 1. That's all. Tr plus 1 minus 1. Simple. That means NCR minus 1. R minus 1. Into a to the power of R minus 1. For 1 less than or equal to R less than. 1 less than or equal to R less than or equal to n plus 1. 1 gets cancelled. Tr equals to ncr minus 1 x to the power of n minus r minus t minus plus 1 a to the power of r minus 1. So this is the formula for rth term. Okay, so this is general term, this is rth term. This is the difference between these two formulas. Okay? This theorem can be proved by mathematical induction by substituting n is equal to 1 and after by substituting n is equal to k. After you can substitute n is equal to k plus 1. You can adjust the formula and you can prove that theorem. Okay? That is the after. Okay? That is the mathematical induction theorem. So dear friends, what you have learned by binomial theorem? Just I will give three simple steps. One is binomial plus or minus. Binomial plus or minus. First number one. Next one is if index is 1, number of terms are n plus 1. Okay, next one is general term, that is tr plus 1, ncr, x to the power of n minus r, a to the power of r. Here xa are real numbers, n is an integer, also integer. Here this formula can also be obtained in x minus a whole to the power of n. Can also be applied when x minus a whole to the power of n is also there. Yes or not? Not only plus, but minus, whenever minus is there, at that time also, you can use this formula. But symbols changes, that's all. Signs changes, that's all. Okay? So, dear friends, this is some important information about binomial theorem. In future classes, we can do some problems regarding binomial theorem. To find required term, we can use this formula. NCR into x to the power of n minus r, a to the power of r, that is r plus 1 term, that is general term, middle term, or last term, or first term, or fifth term, or seventh term, or tenth term, whatever it may be, depends upon the problem. You can use this formula and do the problem, that is ncr equals to factor n by factor r into factor n minus r, and after that you can get the answer. Okay, dear friends, practice this and remember it. Okay dear friends, thanks for watching Matthew YouTube channel. If you like this video, please subscribe our YouTube channel Matthew and hit the bell icons to get more information. Thank you.